Slammery 93, a Legends reunion, is this Sunday, only on pay-per-view, as we go to Gary Capetta in our computerized contender challenge main event.
Here goes, ladies and gentlemen, the following computerized challenge match. It is for the NWA Heavyweight Championship. So for one fall, it's TV Dynamic.
Well, yes, there he is, the contender to the NWA title. And let us mention once again, as we did before, if Johnny B comes away with this win, it will be this Sunday, Johnny B. Badd and Arn Anderson for the NWA title.
Likewise, what could be an interesting matchup. Great rogue, Johnny B. Badd. I've never seen that one before.
And the shower of confetti and ticker tape and whatever as we get ready for the NWA Championship.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this NWA title defense. He's from Sweetwater, Texas. He weighs 278 pounds. The NWA World Heavyweight Champion,
Johnny B. Badd are set to go for the NWA Heavyweight title. A couple of program notes here and things we need to talk about. We ended last week's program with a tremendous amount of controversy surrounding the U.S. title. Rude has the belt. We will next week, we understand, try to solve the controversy, hopefully by talking to both Rude and Dustin Rhodes. And to a WCW official.
I don't understand the controversy.
Well, the controversy was one shoulder was up from one man, one shoulder was up from the other.
Yeah, but the referee made the decision. He handed the belt to Ravishing Rick Rude. Rude has the belt in his possession. Like we just heard on Flair for Gold, possession is 9/10 of the law, right?
I guess. I don't know much about the law. You know a lot about the law, I know.
Well, it is. Rude has the belt. As far as I'm concerned, Ravishing Rick Rude is the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. But as you said, Tony, next week we'll get a ruling from the WCW officials.
Barry Windham and Johnny B. Badd set to go. We'll have more great information about what's coming up next week. Still to come in this program. But this is certainly the biggest moment of Johnny B. Badd's career here, James.
And he's probably facing the biggest opponent of his young career.
Look at this, slugging it out. Johnny B. Badd gets the advantage here. Wow! What a tremendous move by Johnny B. Badd going after Windham, and Windham takes the low road.
Well, fortunately for Barry Windham, the NWA champion, he come down and he hit by the edge of the ropes, allowed him to shoot out between the ropes, and there you can see he's getting grief from the fans, and Johnny B. Badd getting the crowd up into a roar.
You know, this match is certainly... It is really one for the book, so to speak, if I can use that cliche, because here the computer picked Johnny B. Badd as the top contender to Barry Windham's title, when many men like Ron Simmons were very close in getting this title shot.
Well, I'll tell you, some of these computer spin-outs lately, I can only assume our computer's got a virus.
Well, I don't know. Well, arm drag and twist right on the arm, of course. Just a couple of weeks ago, Eric Bischoff and Greg Gagne showed us what the computer had to say. Back to the ropes they go again.
They're our resident computer experts, huh?
Yes, they are.
And look at Windham now. Windham's trash-talking Johnny B. Badd here. Ooh, Badd swinging the left hook. Ref going to make him open them hands up. This is wrestling. It is not boxing.
Certainly, Barry Windham has a great deal of experience advantage over Johnny B. Badd. As far as slugging it out, I would give the advantage to Johnny B. Badd as far as fisticuffs is concerned. But as you pointed out, Jesse, just seconds ago, this is wrestling.
I mean, you can sneak a closed fist in occasionally, which we all know Johnny B. Badd is notorious for doing that, the tutti frutti. But you can bet Windham went to school on him. He knows to watch out for the left. A couple of big elbows there by Big Barry Windham, the champion.
Oh, Johnny B. Badd on the outside. hip that time on the outside, but now back in even more determined than ever. Slamboree is here this Sunday in Windham. Sending Bad. Bad held onto the ropes. Nicely done. Snaps Windham over with a suplex.
Good reversal there by Johnny B. Bad. He used the ropes to his advantage, as you called it, Tony, and changed the tide of the match, and Johnny's got the advantage.
Missed the clothesline. Oh, Windham did not. He decapitated Johnny B. Bad that time, the big Texan. And Bad in major trouble here. We have to take a break. The NWA title continues on Worldwide Fans after this timeout. Stay with us. We're back on WCW Worldwide Wrestling for the NWA title. Over the top goes Johnny B. Bad. On this Slamboree weekend, Barry Windham and Johnny B. Bad going at it for the NWA heavyweight title. The boot across the head of Johnny B. Bad. An argument between Mike Atkins and Barry Windham. Windham come in. And there's those body blows. But Windham absorbs them. Look at it, has his hands hooked right across the leg and sends him down the back suplex.
And a cover.
Windham again gets chased to Johnny B. Bad. Whoa, head first.
Head first into the boot. That's the advantage of being as tall as Barry Windham. You can get that foot up all the way on the top turnbuckle. Sleeper.
And there it is, sleeper hold. Certainly Windham has a tremendous amount of animosity towards one Arn Anderson, but he cannot overlook this match for the NWA title on this Slamboree weekend. He could go to this Sunday's event without the strap.
And good golly, there goes Miss Molly. Down on his back, he's down and out. Referee gonna call it right now. Oh, look at Windham. Brilliant move, feet on the top rope. More leverage applied, referee don't see nothing.
There you hear Mike Atkins warning of the ropes.
Touch him. This camera guy's all over the ropes. What are you talking about?
He's blaming it on the camera guy for crying out loud.
Ask him, you haven't lost it.
Well, what would you do, Tony, admit it? I'll bet you're one of them guys, Tony, you get caught speeding and you admit it, don't you?
No.
Yes, officer, I was doing 85 in a 65.
An argument ensues with a right hand now for Barry Windham. Fans, quickly want to remind you that next week, Sting will be Ric Flair's guest on A Flair for the Gold. That's right. Next week here on Worldwide, Sting will join the Nature Boy and Fifi.
And Bad is hanging up like an old caught salmon right here. Whoa, superplex, it's over.
One, two, and Johnny B. Bad gets out of it.
I can't believe him. He raised up a shoulder on that.
Endurance was one of the factors here in the computer.
He made a liar out of me. I said it was over.
Right hand. Windham is sent into the ropes. Oh, my. One, two, Windham. Oh, that was. Do you realize how close Johnny B. Bad was to be an NWA champ?
Johnny B. Bad came a half a count to scoring the upset of the year so far in 93.
No question about it. And now, trying to continue his momentum. He makes the cover again. One, two again. Whoa. Bad inches, literally inches away from being the NWA champ. One, two, and a two count.
It's hard to keep Big Barry Windham's shoulders on the mat because he is just so long and lanky. He has so much momentum and leverage.
And now Johnny B. Bad with a high risk maneuver. Windham is to his feet. Johnny waiting. Got it. One, two. Oh, my. The closest one yet. The closest one yet for Johnny B. Bad. Windham holds his ground. Missing a right hand. Oh, he moved. Bad. Like a guillotine. The top rope right across the throat.
Johnny B. Bad clotheslined himself when Windham dropped out of the way. Inside rolling cradle, he's got it hooked. Three count. Big win for Barry Windham.